midday.
We got
you could keep, as long as you kept moving, you was okay. 50-55 was fine. You didn't slide or slip. You didn't run out from underneath you. Steering didn't sort of like keep trying to grab out. You just had to be a little careful coming in the turns. And then we got a little further down. We got it up to about 60 for a bit. And we got down at Worthington and I said, yeah, I'll just stop. And then fancy carrying on. Plus I was tired. And I don't like falling asleep at the steering wheel. It's pretty dangerous when you do that. I set my brakes last night and oh, look at that one, let's see straight off. And then this morning, I'm humming a lot, aren't I? I sound like CNN. So we've only got 104 miles to go. But I didn't want to do it last night. It was past midnight when I parked up. 12:30, and I just didn't want to carry on. Hampton, hard tap. We're in a big because I was very tired, woke up this morning. Made myself a cup of tea, had my breakfast. Thank you. then he had to go back over. So then I slowed down. So then he gets in front of me and doesn't go anywhere and does like 30 mile an hour. I'm like, oh, jeez, man. So I go left. I come up and come around him. As soon as I go left to come around him, now he decides he wants to go faster. And I'm like, see, that's what I keep trying to explain to everyone. You have to understand. A good person, a good driver, would acknowledge the conditions, would sit behind another truck, which is I would, just sit there and wait until they get going. If they don't get going, eventually up the road,